may be seated.
Hallelujah.
This psalm here, Psalm 117, gives us two reasons for praising and giving God glory. Two reasons. The first one, His great love towards us. And second, His faithfulness that endures forever. If He did nothing else in this world but give us these two things, He would still be worthy of honor and glory and praise. Amen. Give Him glory. Hallelujah. Brothers and sisters, when you praise the Lord begins to fill you up. When you start praising and giving God glory, He begins to fill you up with His joy. He begins to fill you up with His peace. He begins to fill you up with His strength. He begins to fill you up with His victory. He begins to fill you up with His favor. I think I need to hear, give Him glory right now. Amen. That's right. When you praise the Lord and begin to give Him glory, He will fill you up. And you need to get filled up. Hallelujah. That's right. You need to take time today and take effort in expressing your praise and glory to God. Hallelujah. Take time to communicate your personal gratitude unto the Lord every day. No matter what comes against you, no matter what comes your way, you need to give Him glory. Hallelujah. That's right, brothers and sisters. Psalm 118, 28 says, "You are my God, and I will give you thanks. You are my God, and I will exalt you." Psalm 107, verse 1 says, "Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. His mercy endures forever." Amen. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. You must give God glory, and you must give God thanks, and you must praise Him. Hallelujah. Give Him glory for today. Give Him glory for tomorrow. Hallelujah to Jesus. Are you in the mood to give God glory? You got to wake up with an attitude of giving God glory for your own good. Hallelujah. That's right. You must learn to trust the Lord so strongly that you can thank and praise Him for the things unseen. Hallelujah. Praise and glorify Him for the things that are yet to come. No more looking back. No more looking back. This is a new day. You are a new creation. The Bible says that all things, old things have passed away, and behold, all things have become new. Another verse says that this is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. In other words, don't be looking back at yesterday. Yesterday is gone. Amen. Yesterday is just, it's in the past. What's in front of you today, it's more important than what was left behind. Where God is taking you is far better than where you've come from or wherever you've been. Hallelujah. Nothing will keep you from God's goodness as much as looking backwards. Living in the past, looking backwards at what you left behind. Hallelujah. When you live in the past, you won't give Him glory for today or the things that He has in store for you tomorrow. Because we're too busy looking at the past things that are gone, and you're not focusing on giving Him glory now. What He's doing for you now. Some people think, well, I got nothing to give God praise for. He's done nothing for me. Hallelujah. Take a good look. You're here. You're breathing. You're able to come here without anybody carrying you or helping you here. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Give God glory. Stop looking back. The best days are ahead of you. In Numbers chapter 11, verse 4 through 6, here's the picture of the people of God looking backwards. In this verse here, it shows a multitude of people looking backwards. Numbers 11, 4 says, "Now the mixed multitude who were among them yielded to intense cravings. So the children of Israel also wept again and said, "Who will give us meat to eat? We remember the fish which we ate freely in Egypt, the cucumbers, the melons, the leeks, and the onions and the garlic. But now our whole being is dried up, for there is nothing at all except the manna before our eyes." Hallelujah. The story is about people that are not thankful for what God is doing for them now. Amen. These people, they complain about everything. God had rescued them from the whip of the Egyptians. God had brought them through out of slavery. God had split the sea so they could walk on dry land. And then he closes in the sea and destroyed all their enemies. Hallelujah. He gave them a cloud by day to protect them from the heat. He provided a fire by night to give them light and heat. God was taking care of them, even sending them manna from heaven. But they just wailed, and they just moaned, and they just complained, and they cried about everything. Think about what they're saying. They're saying the melons and the stuff we had freely in Egypt. Really? Freely? They forgot. Amen. That God had rescued them from the whip of the Egyptians. But they're all of a sudden, they don't remember the hard time they went through it. They just remember, hey, we had melons. We had leeks. We had sausage. We had some garlic. We had some onions. And now God is just giving me manna with no flavor, complaining about what God was doing for them. They didn't seem to notice that God was taking care of them, that God was hand feeding them with manna from heaven. Think about it. No toiling, no sowing, no working, no hunting. Just wake up in the morning and breakfast from the hand of God. They didn't seem to notice that. Amen. They were too wrapped up in what God wasn't doing for them that they became ungrateful for what God was doing them in the now. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. They could think of nothing else but what they had left in the past. Sometimes when times get hard, we begin to look back at better times. The times when everything was good. When everything was better, when everything was perfect. But you gotta be careful, because when you start looking back at greater days that you left behind, we begin to be ungrateful for what's in front of us today. Mm. Hallelujah. That's right. They kept on looking backwards. They remembered all the stuff that they had lost and left behind. And the Bible says that their whole being was dried up. Right now, God was giving them manna, taking care of them with everything they needed, and they were looking back at the stuff they lost, and by looking back at what they lost, inside of them began to dry up. Ain't that something? You're getting fed by God, God's taking care of them, and then all of a sudden they think in the past, and now their soul gets dried up like they ain't nothing. God ain't taking care of them. Amen? That's what happens. That's what happened to them. Satisfaction came to their hearts when their attention shifted from what they had to what they don't have now or what they want. Amen? They're like, no fish, no melons, no onions, no garlic, no spices. What kind of God do we have that can't even give me a little garlic, a little bit of onions put on my manna? Really? Amen? Amen. Their mind was on what they left behind. What occupied your mind this morning? Where's your mind on? On the wonderful times when times were better? When you found that great job, or when everything was working out good, and you think back, I wish it was like that again. I wish it was that time when I came up, or that time when I had a good job, or that time when my car was running really well, and now I just got this Pinto. It gets gets me to work, but it ain't got no sound system in it, ain't got no wheels, it's got dents, it's primer. You're not focusing that God is providing you still a car to get somewhere, amen? And all we think about are all the stuff that go on, and hallelujah to Jesus. Are you giving God glory for what God has been giving you? Or are you always thinking about what you had or what you would like to have? It's just a question. You must be careful on these times and not to forget what God is doing for you now. Now, hallelujah, you must have a thankful attitude towards God, giving Him thanks, giving Him glory, giving Him praises, exalting Him every day. God has more for you. Amen. That's right. We need to stop looking back, because your best days are right in front of you. Woo! Stop looking at the good things you've had. God has far better things in your future. God has better in store for the children of God. Amen. Stop dwelling on what's wrong. Stop dwelling on all the things that ain't working out, and start giving God glory for the things He's doing right. Yeah. Amen. Any situation you walk into, don't look at the worst case scenario. Look at the best case scenario. Amen. That's right, because it's easy to focus on the worst case scenario. We got to fix our mind on the good stuff God's doing. Amen. God is holding our hand. God is walking us through the valley of the shadow of death. He's going to take care of us. Amen. Throughout the day, give Him praise. Throughout the day, give Him glory for His goodness. Even when things don't go your way, just know that things are going God's way. Amen. When things ain't going your way, don't be upset. Things are going exactly the way God wants them to be. Exactly. We can't figure it out, but He can. Sometimes He's setting up a situation for you. Sometimes He has to take you through the valley to get you to the mountaintop. Right now, maybe He's walking you through the valley. But if you stop complaining and keep moving, He's gonna, pretty soon you're gonna be going up. The valley goes down, but there's also a part where you start coming back up again. God's walking you through it, and that's where you're gonna end up. On top of the mountain, but it's all on your attitude. If you give Him praise, I believe you'll get there faster. If you moan and complain, then you ain't learned nothing yet. You need to stay in the valley a little bit longer. Give Him thanks for what He's doing. But if you start moaning, what did He do to the Israelites? Another round the mountain they go. They complain some more. There you go around. The promised land's right there within a day or two. They could have got there any time, but they complained. So are you going around the mountain? Going around the mountain every time you complain. One more lap. You complain again. One more lap. Keep complaining. One more lap. How many times are you going to take that off? How many times are you going to run that same lap before we realize complaining and moaning against God and murmuring ain't a way to get from around that mountain? Amen. Amen. Giving Him thanks, giving Him glory is what gets us on that higher ground. Amen. When you get some bad news or some problem comes your way, that's when you have to know that God is always in control. Praise Him for that. Say, Lord, I know You got control of this. People are coming against me, my situation, my circumstances, but You, Lord, got me. Amen?
Amen.
Give Him glory no matter what the situation looks like. I want to get you blessed. Today, God wants me to get you blessed. And I believe that the best way and the quickest way to the blessing is through praise and glory to God. Amen. That's right. That's right. We all have gone through some stuff in the past. But it's not the end for us. It's not the end for us. Amen. When one door closes, God will open another one. He says in Revelation 3:7, He opens doors that no one can shut, and He shuts doors that no one can open. Once God opens up a door for you, ain't nobody closing it. But also, when He closes a door behind you, you can't get back there either. You can't go back to a door that's already closed. So your past, He's already closed that door. That chapter's behind us. We have to look ahead, amen? That's right. God always wants to give you a fresh start. God is still has a great plan for you today. Amen? That's right. That's right. I know our God this morning, brothers and sisters, and our God is an awesome God. He's an all-powerful God. He's already given us the main biggest victory. He saved you from the pit of hell.
Amen.
He washed you in His blood. Well, that's the biggest thing. You don't think He can do anything else? If He snatched you, plucked you out of the fire, you don't think He can get you out of any other trouble? He can and He will. But we gotta start giving Him maximum glory. If you can learn to give God glory, you'll see better days. Amen? That's right. There ain't no doom and gloom for the children of God. For the people out there, that's doom and gloom. They're done. They're finished. But not us. Amen? Not us. You must keep yourself fired up. When you wake up in the morning, decide to give God glory first. Hallelujah. It's a choice you gotta make. It's a decision that you gotta make. Decide that you're going to live with praise and glory towards God in your heart. If you are not living with praise and glory in your heart, you need to start today. Don't wait any longer. Get up each morning and give God glory. That's the title. Give God glory. You wake up praising the Lord, giving Him glory. I guarantee you it's going to be a great day. Wake up giving God glory. It's going to be a good day. Amen. Wake up with the song of praise. Wake up with the song in your heart. No matter what your situation is. You know that God, I want to put this on your mind. When we're thinking about the past, think about your situation right now. Right now, God has given you gifts and talents and abilities to do some incredible stuff. Amen. That's right. Inside of you right now, there's untapped talents. You got talents in you that you ain't tapped into. You got gifts of the Spirit that they're there already. They were given to you the day you met the Lord Jesus. He's equipped you with everything you're already going to do. All you got to do is tap into it. And the way you tap into it is by giving Him thanks and glory. Amen? That's right. That's how you ignite the talents and the gifts that are inside of you. Praise and glory is the match that lights the fire. Amen? That's right. That's what will light up the talents in you. Praising and giving Him glory will light you up. You got stuff inside of you that God's already put in there. We ain't even got to ask Him for this stuff. He's already given it to us. Each and every child of God has it. Now the way we tap into it, again, is by singing glory to His name. We want the talent, we want the gift, we don't want to give them thanks and honor and glory, then it's not going to work. We got to start off, thank you, Lord, that I got talents. Thank you, Lord, that I'm blessed. Thank you, Lord, that you gave me the wisdom to be a prophet or healing or a teacher or just a lover or a forgiver. Or a good husband, or a good wife. He's already equipped you with all this stuff. And now instead of keep asking Him for it, we thank Him already. Thank you that you put this in me. Thank you that you created me in your image. Thank you that you put these abilities and talents in me. Thank you when you start giving Him glory, that activates that stuff in you. Amen? We just want to read the Word, but we got power already given to us. Already in us, and we just got to learn to tap into that source of power that we got from God and just work it. Amen? Somehow, some way, you got to get yourself to praise the Lord and thank Him for that stuff. Amen? Start the day by making melody in your heart unto the Lord. Sing praise. Make a joyful noise. Even if you don't do it out loud, but in your heart, under your breath, when you're in the shower, when you're brushing your sung in the shower. You know, we sing all them songs here on the radio. We'll sing some praises. Change your tune. Amen. No more running with the devil. How about running with the Lord? Hallelujah. Amen. Start singing that stuff. Because that's what we sing. We don't say it, but sing all those other songs, we're really singing unto the Lord, I mean, unto the devil. And, you know, those songs are catchy. I hear them on the radio all the time. I don't even say those words anymore. I'm hearing the song Running with the Devil, but I ain't saying that. I'm saying I'm running with the Lord. I'm not running with the devil. I'm singing along saying, nah, the opposite, amen? I shouldn't even be doing that, but at least I'm changing the words. I ain't agreeing. I ain't saying what they're saying. I got my own lyrics I put in there. Amen? Yeah. That's right. That's what we got to do, brother and sister. God wants to have our praise and glory. Yeah. He does it. He won't demand that we give to him, but he gets pleased when we do. Amen? He begins to release. He starts to go on the edge of his seat and say, yeah. Something with somebody who's constantly giving them thanks and glory. He could do something with somebody that sings to the Lord. He could do somebody that's always lifting them up, always exalting them, always putting them first, always talking about them, always mentioning it in every situation. He's like, that's my boy, that's my girl. Yeah, yeah, I'll equip him more. If he's going to go out and be giving me glory, if he's going to be going out and giving me praise, if he's going to go out and talk about me, then man, I'm going to equip him even more. Amen. He's going the right way. But if we're going the wrong way, I can't give you any more because you're using it the wrong way. But if whatever we use to give God glory, he'll give you more. Amen. He'll give you more. You bless him with your time, he'll give you more time in the day. Bless him with your love, he'll fill you up with love. You bless him with your finances, he'll give you more finances. That's how it works. Sometimes we want to get fruit from seeds we ain't planted. We give love, so hey, we're getting that back. You plant love, you're going to get love. You plant forgiveness, you're going to get forgiveness. You want your finances to be better, then you got to plant a financial seed. If I plant an orange tree, I ain't getting an apple. I'm getting back the seed I plant. If you want and your finances to get better and nobody wants to hear it because the preacher wants your money, I want to ride, I want to freaking Escalade, put money in the plate. See, when your mentality's that way, then you're not sowing any seeds where you want the harvest. You want the harvest in finance, then you got to plant finance. If you want a seed of, you know, great relationship with your wife, then you got to sow that way. Anything you sow, reap what you sow. So if I'm not sowing any money, I'm not sowing any time, I'm not sowing any talents, I'm not sowing any ability, then but if I sow towards the world, if I sow towards bad things, then that's what I'm going to reap, amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. The seed you plant is the fruit you're going to get. Can I get an amen?
Amen.
That's right. God gives the victory as we sing, as we pray, as we glorify him. So I say, if that's true, keep on singing. Keep on giving him glory. Keep on lifting up his name. Don't go around all negative, speaking destruction. Keep speaking disaster. Speaking about how heavy your circumstances are. And dragging around all day, depressed. Change your mind. Change your mind. Go a different direction, amen? That's right, brothers and sisters. Ephesians 5:18 says, ever be filled with the Spirit. Ever. You don't just get filled up one time and then live happily ever after. The scripture says, on a daily basis, you must continuously be filled with the Spirit of God. And the only way you begin to be filled with the Spirit of God, if you start calling on the Spirit of God, say, Lord, I need you. Lord, come into my life. Lord, be with me here today in this transaction, in this deal, in this road that I'm going, in this place I'm going to fill out an application for a job, in this thing I'm going to do, or whatever. Include God in it. And let him lead. Don't lead God. So God, I'm going to get into this business, and you better be with me. Amen. Say, Lord, you point the direction. You tell me where to be. And if you're where God wants you to be, it'll be blessed, no doubt. You don't just get filled up once. You get ever filled. The way to stay full and the way to overcome the pressures of life is by keep singing the song that God has put in your heart. You know that the Bible says that He gave you a new song? When you became a child of God, He gave you a new song, meaning He gave you a new tune. All that, I can't do it, it's too hard, the circumstance is too big, that's an old song. That's the old song. You got a new song. I can do everything through God. If God on my side, ain't nothing gonna stop me. That's a new song. Amen. Amen. That's right. That's right. All through the day, praise God and give Him glory. Let the song ring out. Begin to dance in your heart, just like David. Amen. David got around that Ark of the Covenant. He was getting down. Amen. He didn't care who was singing them. Amen. Couldn't dance, but he moved like he could dance. Amen. I wasn't there, but you know, it's good. See, we could learn a lot from David. David turned all his prayers. He started off praying, Lord, my enemies, and then he started off praying for all the things God wanted to do. And then at the end of the psalm, it turned into praise. It never stayed. It went boo hoo hoo. Hey, Lord, thank you. You're gonna do it. It always turned in to positive prayer. Amen. He starts off by asking God, then he says, because your loving kindness is better than life, my lips shall praise you. I will bless you while I live. I will lift up my hands in your name. My soul shall be satisfied as marrow and fatness to my bones, and my mouth shall praise you with joyful lips every day. That's what we gotta have. Amen. The best way to come up against the enemy is to start praising God. Amen. Sometimes we tell God of how big our enemy is. And God, what's God, you know, what does that scare God? We got to start talking to the enemy about how great our God is. Amen. You know what, Satan? The Lord is my Savior. The Lord is bigger than you are. Anything you pull, God already handled it. God's got all the remedy. God is the one who made you, and He can destroy you. Start telling the devil some truth about God. Amen. We're telling God what He already knows. Hey, I'm in trouble. I'm in a situation. Oh, poor me, oh my. Woe is me, woe is me. Nobody likes me, nobody loves me. My circumstances, it's gonna take me under. Ooh. I wish it was like last year when everything was good. I wish it was last 10 years it was better. But now these last 2 years, ooh. Amen. Start telling the devil, you're a liar, devil. The Lord is for me, and anybody against me is going to go down. You're defeated. I already have the victory over you. Nothing you say can do anything. Hallelujah. That's right. And I'll leave you with the last psalm, Psalm 105:1-3. It says, give thanks to the Lord and call on His name. Make known among the nations what He has done. Sing to Him. Sing praise to Him. Tell of all His wonderful works. Give His holy name glory. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. See, He's telling you here. Sing. Tell people of the goodness of God. He didn't say, when you're on the mountaintop, do it. He just said, do it. At all times. At all times. Psalm 118:28, you are my God, and I will give you glory. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Let's stand and exalt God.